my beautiful little chai lattes. I said really recently I was gonna just start calling you guys things that I really love, and I want that to stick. Like, I've tried out the whole naming my subscribers thing and it never seems to stick. I always feel like such an idiot when I call you guys like a specific name, so I'm just gonna start calling you whatever I love during the day. And today it is chai lattes because your girl is sick, in case you can't hear by my super nasally voice. But I really wanted to get out my January favorites, and I skipped my December favorites, and I hate skipping favorites videos because I obviously try a ton of new stuff every single month, and I really want to let you guys know what I liked, what didn't work for me. They're literally my favorite videos to film, so I just thought I would drag my cold medicine hopped up ass out of bed so that I could film a little something something for you guys. Also, this makeup look will be up fairly soon, probably within the next couple of weeks. I am traveling so much. When you're watching this video, I'm like back in LA for something. So this hermit crab like thrives on being able to like lounge around in my gross sweatpants for days on end in between like fancy people events and whatnot. So be patient with me while I kind of try to churn these videos out for you. But I'm already rambling, I've already been filming forever, so I'm gonna just start getting into my favorites. We're gonna start off with clothes. In the middle of the month, I actually went to Cabo with Pure Cosmetics, and I'm gonna link down below my little let's go on an adventure video for Cabo. Side note, some people were really confused about that video. I'm going to start doing travel diaries and call them let's go on an adventure because I love documenting my trips and my adventures and stuff, and I just thought that would be kind of cute, so you guys are like going on the adventure with me. But this swimsuit is from Victoria's Secret, and that was what I wanted to point out because everyone in their mother was asking in the vlogs, in my selfies, and everything that I was posting where the swimsuit was from. It has a lot of padding down here, so it makes the boobs look pretty nice. I always have to wear a strap with these sorts of tops because my chest is a little bit smaller. It needs some lifting up. So this is what I wore in Cabo. I wore a few bikinis. I actually filmed a plus size swimwear lookbook that will be out soon. But this top everyone asked about, so I just thought I would let you know. It's Victoria's Secret pink, and then the bottoms that I actually paired with it are these really pretty mint green ones, and these are from Forever 21 Plus. I don't know if they have them in this exact shade this year. They may have a slightly different tone of mint. They sort of change out the shades of these high-waisted bikinis every year. So yeah, that is the bottoms that I paired with it, and they're slightly off from the minty shade on the bikini, but just barely, and I thought it worked really well. My next favorite I already got in Cabo, and it looks so freaking gross, you guys. Like, when I was in LA, I actually dropped this in a puddle because I can't stop taking it everywhere with me. This is just because I wear this thing probably every single day at some point. This is a Social Hustler hoodie that Pure Cosmetics gave us, but the brand is Soul Food Mafia, and I love this company so ridiculously much. No, they are not sponsoring me. No, I do not have an affiliate link. Part of the sales go to charity, and you can pick the charity that your sale kind of goes to. The material of these sweatshirts is so, so ridiculously soft that I cannot get over it. Like, that's why I've been wearing it, honestly, because the material is so cozy and warm, and it's just like, I don't know, I really, really freaking love it. It also covers my butt, which is really nice because I love hoodies that cover the boo-hiney, so I can wear lots of leggings and or shorts and or nothing with them. YOLO. Soul Food Mafia has a really special place in my heart, and I just wanted to show them some love. So if you guys go and follow them on Instagram or shop on the website, please let them know that I sent you, because I think it's a really cool company and you guys will really, really like the stuff. So that is my favorite real clothing item of the month, TBH. I literally wore it every single day. I wore this sweater 3 times in 1 month, and I feel like, and I'm not talking like around the house, you know, like where no one sees you and it doesn't matter. Like, I wore this out as an outfit 3 different times this month, and I think it's just because I love it so much. This is from Red Dress Boutique, but as you can see, it's a really, really massive, like super baggy sweater. It has this open shoulder detail, really nice, like long, well, maybe sleeves, long sleeves, and I just think it's so ridiculously comfy. It is nice and stretchy, and I don't know, there's something about this that is just so freaking cute and flattering. Even though it's gigantic and super baggy, the way that it hits on the body and the way that it falls, it doesn't make you look bigger than you actually are. And I do have a video with Red Dress coming up where I will kind of show you guys how I style this, but I've worn it with jeans, I've worn it with leggings, I've worn it over a bathing suit, and I'm obsessed with it. I'm so, so in love with this sweater. Plus the color is like on point for the upcoming spring season. I'm already like in spring mode. I've never wanted warm weather so bad in my entire life. Anyways, that is it for my fashion favorites. Moving into hair, I really only have one favorite to talk about, and it is always my Numi 32mm curling wand, and I mention this especially when people start asking about hairstyles. This month in particular, I really rocked this sort of like really long ponytail, and I will do a tutorial, but essentially all you do for this is you stack one pony on top of another. Actually, I have a get ready with me coming up where I do show how to do that pony. Whenever it's out, I will link it down below. But it's really, really simple, and the way that I like to do it the best is when I curl my hair with a Numi 32mm curling wand, because I really only need to curl the ends of my hair, but it gives it so much body. It makes it look like it's all one continuous super long pony, and I just love it. So this is my secret weapon. Numi has a lot of really cool coupons going on that I will have for you guys down below. They are letting you guys stack free shipping over $50 with any offer on the site. So it's not like you buy a curling wand full price and get free shipping, like woohoo. Like, it literally is free shipping with any other offer. That's a big deal. They really don't do free shipping very often, and I think that it's only free US shipping, and I'm really sorry to my international viewers, but I just thought I would let you guys know. I will have some coupons for you down below, and you can get my favorite curling wand ever for a little bit cheaper. Of course, when I'm talking about this, I'm just like rocking the natural hair texture and being a lion. I don't talk skincare too much on my channel, but I'm getting more and more into it, especially as I'm getting a little bit older, starting to take some preventative care of my skin. I'm only 22, so I'm not using like anti-aging creams or anything too regularly, but I wound up swapping over to the Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Lotion Plus. Now, I got this baby size because I am traveling like crazy here recently, it seems like. So I got this and I just kind of thought maybe it would be a very non-offensive moisturizer. Like, my skin is very sensitive. I was like, if it breaks me out, it breaks me out, but I need something small for this trip, and I didn't have too long to research. But the research that I did do, everyone was like, this lotion is amazing. It's the best moisturizer ever. I do not like it better than my Cetaphil Everyday Moisturizer, the daily moisturizer with SPF 15. But it is a really close competitor, and when I feel like my skin needs a little bit less moisture, I really feel myself going to this. So I think that this may be my go-to in the summer. The only thing with this is that it doesn't have SPF, so you have to add that in somewhere else, obviously, to protect your skin from the damage that the sun does deliver. But overall, I really love it, and I'm so excited that I tried it. All right, so let's talk makeup. The first chunk of this month, I was home visiting my family in Georgia, and I found this in my bedroom at my dad's house, realized I had bought it the previous summer and left it there, completely forgot about it, never even opened up the foundation. Maybe I did, maybe I tried it once, but I was so excited because it was like a brand new product I got to use. So I have this in the shade 4.0, which is obviously my fake tan color. I'm not super tan right now, but I'm obsessed with this. Like, it's really weird. I was telling my friend the other day, I feel like I break out when I don't put this on my skin. It's almost like my skin got really accustomed to this, and now I'm trying to use other things and use my old foundations and stuff, and my skin's just like, nope. Nope, found the holy grail, like, go back to it. It is really, really good. My only thing is I wish it did have better coverage. Like, it's a very serum-y foundation and it does have good coverage, but I almost wish it was more since my skin is so accustomed to it and it, like, wants nothing else. I can always take away, but it's hard to add into a foundation, like additional coverage power and stuff, but I really like it overall, and honestly, like, it wears a really long time, it doesn't oxidize, it looks amazing on my dry skin. The other foundation is actually from Pure Cosmetics, and they gave me this ultra, ultra bougie version that's like all bedazzled out. Do you guys see that? I'm like horrified that I'm even using this because I never want it to run out of product. But I have been using their 4-in-1 Pressed Mineral Makeup with SPF 15, and I've been using this in the shade Golden Medium when I'm about this shade. I love this stuff, and I've started even just buffing it over moisturizer when I feel like I don't want to be as dewy as my moisturizer often leaves me because I am so dry skin. Like, I have really heavy moisturizer. This obviously takes away the shine. It adds a little bit of coverage, but I can also layer it over foundation, and I really, really like this stuff. Not huge on powder foundation, but I just feel like this one is so, like, non-intrusive. Like, it doesn't really grab onto dry patches. It just looks so flawless on. Like, you can't even tell where I'm blending it, but it adds a nice little layer of coverage and makes things look a little bit better than they actually are. So, love this bad boy. Also, I should mention that right about now, I would consider myself the shade light, just in case you were wondering. Face brush I discovered last month that I've been using a ton is this e.l.f. something 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 I don't freaking know, magical unicorn butt hair brush. Like, this is the best brush, and I've been using it lately to contour because I don't really like a harsh line of contour anymore. I really like the results that this gives because it is a little bit more pointed, but it's also fluffy. So if I take it and I'm really light-handed and I'm just kind of going right here under the cheeks, it sculpts it out without being a line, and I love it. It does all of the blending work for me in one step. I'm obsessed with it. I've been using it a ton, and it's so inexpensive. I will have the proper like brush listed and linked down below, but you guys absolutely need this one. It's so stupidly soft. Like, it feels like an It Cosmetics brush. If you took the e.l.f. handle off of this and we were playing a game and you were like, who made this brush? I would be like, It Cosmetics, don't shoot me, because don't want to be shot. And I don't know why you're shooting me. I don't know when this game got so dark, but it feels so, so soft, and I could just like rub it on my face all day. A few more face products I really enjoyed was this MAC blush in the shade Spellbinder. I mentioned this in my MAC haul, which was filmed right at the end of December, probably like December 26th or 27th. So my Christmas decorations were still up. People were really mad about it. But this was from the Fairy Whispers collection, which I've checked. This blush is definitely still available. I love the color of this, and I've been wearing it almost every single day. Because it is such a light peachy flush, I feel like it's definitely getting me kind of ready for spring. I've been doing slightly lighter, more neutral makeup looks here recently, but it just goes with everything. It has a little bit of a sheen to it, and it makes my skin look alive, like very, very healthy. I love it, and I wish I had like a drugstore alternative, but there's something about this. Like, when I turn my hand, it almost has, I don't know if you guys can even tell, it has like the slightest bit of a duochrome to it. Like, it flashes a little bit corally gold when I turn my hand sometimes, and it's so, so pretty. So I've been using that a lot. My new favorite highlighter of the month was this Pure Afterglow Illuminating Powder. I don't think I use this on camera very much, but I used it a lot off camera. Number one, love the color of this. Just a really nice pale, light golden shade. However, the shimmer is so fine. Like, this isn't a subtle highlighter. Like, you are going to glow, baby, glow once it's on the skin, but it's very finely milled and it does not catch on to any impurities on my skin, any imperfections. It's just like, nope, I got you, boo. You are just glowing for days. So I've been doing the strobing thing, especially on very, very minimal makeup days where I just highlight, because I'm obsessed with the glow that it gives to my skin. It adds in a dewy effect without actually having to be dewy, because I love looking dewy, girl. And I can't handle how patchy my makeup can get on top of it, because I'm not using cream bronzers, I'm not using cream blusher, any of that stuff. I'm using powders, and when a foundation is very dewy, your products, your powder products anyways, can get kind of patchy. This really adds back in that glow where you want it, and it's magic. I love it so ridiculously much. Talking eyeshadow, one of my favorite palettes of the month was absolutely this e.l.f. palette, and I think that this is temporarily sold out. I'm not 100% on it, but I know it's called the 20 Pan Artist Palette. I did like an entire video featuring this palette that I will link down below, but these shadows are so buttery, so creamy. They feel like high-end shadows, and I'm so beyond impressed with the pigmentation, the blendability, the quality here. I'm so in love, and I just had to give it a little mention, because even if it is sold out permanently, and I'm really sorry about that, hopefully we can like tell e.l.f. that this is an absolute, like, what am I doing? Just like, look at my swatches. But like, hopefully we can tell e.l.f. this is an absolute winning formula, and they need to do more stuff in this formulation, because it is so, so ridiculously good. The entire palette was like $20, and I loved it so much. And I know that I already kind of like showed it in a video, so I'm not going to talk too much longer. Check out the tutorial down below. And then my other favorite combo of the month was something I did mention in my drugstore favorites of 2015. And this is Maybelline's Bad to the Bronze color tattoo thing. And this is just a really pretty bronzy shade. And I'm gonna layer these over each other so you can see what I do. So here's the cream shadow. So I'll kind of like blend that all over the lid, you know, just work it on in there so I have a little bit of something something. And then immediately over that, while the shadow is still tacky, I like to take NYX's Baked Shadow in the shade Ambrosia. And this is such a cool color because it is pigmented, but the way that it's formulated, it's very, very thin, and so it just glides over this like tacky cream shadow so well. I really love this combo. It turns into a coppery rose gold color. The more ambrosia you add, the more of that copper feel you get. I do really smoky looks with this where I barely add any of that baked shadow. I do really, really natural looks where it's just something super shimmery and rose gold on the lid. This is my favorite combination, and if you have a few bucks to spend at the drugstore, I definitely recommend it. Sorry guys, my camera needed to take a little break. My lippy of the month was definitely Urban Decay Ex-Girlfriend. And of course, you know, I went back to some standard faves I've mentioned a million times, but Urban Decay Ex-Girlfriend really wound up wowing me this month because this is from the Urban Decay Gwen Stefani line, in case you do not know. And this is really cool because it is a little bit more of a sheer, nudie pink color. It is literally my lip color, but shinier and better, and obviously like it evens things out. So I've been wearing it a ton on minimal makeup days, on full glam days. It is like my go-to at the moment. I discovered this mascara this month, and when I pull out the wand for this, you're gonna be like, that is nothing. Like, it doesn't look special. This is the Pure Volume Vixen 4-in-1 Mascara, and if you guys don't have an issue with length, like my lashes aren't super long, but they're not like, I'm wearing falsies today, I don't know why I touched them, like, oh, these are mine. My issue is with volume. All of my lashes are very, very thin. I have a really hard time looking like I have more than like 5 lashes. This mascara is the king of everything. The wand does not look special. It just looks like a standard bristle wand, but literally, you guys, it makes you look like you have the best lashes, and I'm not just saying that. Obviously, this was gifted to me by Pure. We were on our trip, but I've tried out a few mascaras. I thought they were good, but this one just really, really took the cake, and I had to mention it because it's so amazing. Definitely worth the splurge if you guys are in the market for a new mascara. My perfume of the month, mostly because I was traveling, is Juicy Couture by Juicy Couture. I was gifted this in a little set by a friend of mine for Christmas, and I just love this perfume so much. It's a little spray pen too, which, like, I hate rollerballs. I hate them. I feel like I never smell like anything when they leave my skin. Like, it kind of smells like it, but I feel like sprayers are the way to go. They actually leave that, I just sprayed that in entirely the wrong direction. They actually leave the scent behind, but this is just a really florally scent that's not too overpowering, and I really, really like it for all seasons. Like, I don't feel like it's too spring. I don't feel like it's like incredibly, incredibly winter. I can taste it. I shouldn't be talking while it's like still floating in the air, but am I gonna like die? I feel like I'm already kind of dying, like, of this mysterious flu illness, so what are you gonna do? But yeah, I've been using this because it is small, it is portable, I can fit it in that little plastic baggie. I don't have one sitting around, but the plastic bag that you have to get through TSA with, so I've just been carrying it around 24/7. And that is it for my beauty favorites. I'm gonna talk about some music because obviously listening to music a lot. Also, I am on my old iPhone. My other one is charging right now because it's super dead, and I just picked this one up because I basically use it as an iPod lately. The thing about Spotify I really don't like is my playlist did not transfer over even after I logged into Spotify. So it's like I have to remake everything, and that's really obnoxious. But anyways, 2 of my 3 favorite songs of the month are actually from Justin Bieber's new album. The first one is Sorry, which you probably heard me jamming out to on Snapchat the other day. Literally just one of my favorite songs at the moment. I jumped on the bandwagon with this entire album way too late, but I love every song on here. Last month I loved What Do You Mean? This month it has been Sorry, and it has also been Love Yourself. Honestly, I thought this was gonna be like a body positive anthem, like TBH, I thought that was what it was gonna be about, and it's like not. It's kind of like a pseudo diss track. And honestly, like, I had a lot of pent up emotion this month, and I cannot even get into any of the stuff that happened. Like, honestly, it is just such a good song, and I love it so much. My last one is a completely different feel from those first two, but it is called My Demons by Starset. I will link this down below as well. I just really, really like this song. It's kind of like a rock song, but it's really good for cardio, in case you're curious. But those are my favorite songs of the moment. And then my favorite movie that I watched this month, like my favorite Netflix thing, was actually called The Veil, and I rated it 4 stars on Netflix because it could have been better. It was a little bit predictable, but this is a 2016 movie. I may have actually watched this month. Now I'm not sure, but you guys definitely need to go and watch it if you are horror movie fans. Like, it is so good. Jessica Alba is in it, and the girl, she's in American Horror Story, and I can, Lily Rabe, she's in it too. But it was a really good movie, and I thought it was really, really interesting. I thought it was really good, and I do recommend it. I'm not gonna give away any of the plot details because I just think it's a really good movie, and if you are a horror movie buff, I do think it's really nice. That is it for my favorites video. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you have not already. Let me know some of your favorites in the comments down below. I'm gonna go and crawl back into bed and probably not film again for like 2 weeks because I'm so tired. I'm so sick. And the traveling is about to start all over again. But I will see you guys so soon. Make sure to subscribe to my vlog channel, by the way, if you ever just want to keep up with the day-to-day, because I film a lot of vlogs, especially right now. It's like I take you guys everywhere. But I love you guys so much, and I will see you in the next video. Bye. I'm dying.